Research shows we have about 6 liters of blood pumping through our bodies. That's equivalent to about 3 2-liter bottles of soda. Doctors say if we lose just 1 liter of blood, that could lead to a life or death situation. When patients are rushed to Barnes Jewish Hospital with life-threatening bleeding and injuries, Dr. Laurie Punch, a Washington University trauma surgeon, scrubs for surgery, then heads to the operating room.
I don't think I can continue my work in trauma surgery without doing something that works on preventing the lives lost that I see in this hospital every day.
Gun violence has claimed more than 175 lives in St. Louis this year, including children.
I cannot see another beautiful dead body. I can't hold the hands of mamas and children. I cannot show up to another morning report where we hear about a life lost.
Grieving lives lost goes beyond friends and families.
I can't contain it. I either succumb to that grief and say, well, this is going to do my job, and fall into my own depression and burnout, which happens to a lot of health professionals. Instead, I'm turning that and desperately, intentionally trying to do what I can to work outside these walls.
Stop the Bleed is a national campaign that we've championed here locally in St. Louis.
Dr. Punch moves from the emergency room to the classroom seamlessly with desperate determination.
How many of you heard about this class through the YMCA?
Training ordinary people how to do an extraordinary thing. Stop life-threatening bleeding.
We teach an ABC 1-2-3 stop the bleed, okay? First, check your surroundings and be safe.
Her approach is simple but urgent.
That it takes 5 minutes for someone to bleed to death, depending on where they're hurt.
Students in this Stop the Bleed class have high expectations.
I hope to learn to save a life.
And are eager to learn. Pool noodles are used to help teach life-saving techniques.
And try that two-hand fingertip pressure that's in that drawing there.
Students are taught how to use their fingers to apply direct pressure to severe wounds.
I want you to pack the big ones, the little ones. And you got to do it right.
How to pack them with gauze.
You put it on like a belt.
And how to properly use a tourniquet.
Make sure you check it all the way inside.
Everyone here, including children, say they are prepared to act.
I'll know how to stop the bleeding.
I believe I'll know what to do.
In fact, it was a tragedy involving kids that led to the Stop the Bleed campaign.
And that was the tragic shooting, Sandy Hook Elementary in Newtown, Connecticut.
Dr. Punch remembers that horrific day.
I got a text from a friend, pray for my friend that can't find her daughter.
About a half hour later, she received another message.
She texted me back, two words, she's gone.
Close personal ties to one of the worst school shootings in U.S. history.
Say his name!
Xavier!
And devastating gun violence in St. Louis drives Dr. Punch.
This is something that's relevant not just to the possibility of a school shooting, as tragic as that is, but something that's relevant to everyday life.
Now, if you are interested in taking a Stop the Bleed class, they are being taught every hour on the hour this Friday at the T Education Center from 9 in the morning until 7 in the evening. Now, the T is located at 5874 Del Mar Boulevard in St. Louis. Head to our Fox 2 Now app to learn more about those classes.
And we saw the classes she was teaching there. How many people in St. Louis have taken it thus far? Are there a lot of people involved
in
this?
Yeah, about 6,000 people throughout the St. Louis region have already taken that class, Mandy. 1 million around the world, but the goal is to teach 200 million people globally. And those who participate in the class also get one of these trauma first aid kits, which includes a tourniquet and other emergency supplies.
Interesting story. Yep.
That really is information that we could all
use. We
could
all use, as she said. It is relevant to everyday life.
Yeah. All right, Shirley. Great story.
Also new tonight.